Hey everyone, Rich with Mustang Connection, thanks for stopping by. And that little sequence in the beginning there that I put before this intro, that's my car driving back to the transmission shop, the 69 GT. It's got a bad trans leak, and truthfully I paid to have the trans done, so they got to get it right. That's where it is right now, but I thought I would cover something that's kind of cool. I've done this before, some of the documentation on little tidbits that make your car, just add to the kind of the provenance of the vehicle. So I came across this gentleman, Tony Garcia. He owns Mustang stickers. And what he does is replicate the original window stickers. It's really cool. So he sent me a pair. This one's been laminated. It's really neat. And he sent me one that's loose, kind of loose leaf. So I have one that's laminated, one that's loose leaf. And this is a replica of the original window sticker. Now, he can work off of a build sheet, an original invoice. I had this one upside down. Or the Marty report. In my case, I sent him the Marty report. I do have the original build sheets. The problem with the original build sheet, as I will show you, is just too delicate. It's too hard to read it. Now, there is a way to clean these, I believe. Acetone, I heard, will clean off a lot of this discoloration, but I didn't want to go through that. But anyway, point being, you really can't. This isn't legible. So the build sheet wasn't going to work. As a result, I sent him the Marty report. But what you really need is this gives you all the information on your car, what everything cost. Really cool. Down to the, every little thing that car was ordered with is on this window sticker. And I'm going to go over, I think it's kind of a neat thing to kind of go through this. And even though the car's not behind me right now, we've got the 65, I'll pop up some photographs of the car and some video and talk about some of the options, because the car is pretty loaded. Amazingly. In fact, almost twice as much in options. The car was $2,700 new. You see that right there? $2,700. And here's what you got at no extra cost. Floor-mounted shift lever, vinyl bucket seats, dual headlamps. So they weren't going to charge you extra to have headlamps. Color-keyed carpeting. And a push-button seat belt. So those were the standard equipment on a little coupe. Now, the base engine on this would have been an inline six-cylinder. This car, however, is a 351 four-barrel car. And that cost $84 to have that installed in your little coupe. And you can see it says Royal Maroon there, no charge. And then further down, it says two-tone hood paint. It was $20, $19.48. That is that low gloss, semi-flat blackout treatment on the hood. And let's see, select shift FMX cruise-o-matic transmission was $200. The GT equipment group was $146. So what the GT equipment group came with in 1969, let's kind of go through this, and again I'll flash a photo or some video up. So let's go, what the 69 GT group got was essentially similar equipment that the Mustang Mach 1 would have got. However, you could get the coupe or convertible in GT trim, where the Mach 1 only came in the sports roof slash fastback style, if you will. So if you ordered a GT in 69, you could put it on a coupe, convertible, or a sports roof. Additionally, the base engine for the GT in 69 was a 351 two-barrel, so you couldn't get a GT with a 302. So the base engine would have been a 351 two-barrel. The step up from that would have been the four-barrel 351, and in 69 you could have got a 390 or a 428 Cobra Jet, either the R code, which is the Ram Air, or the Q code, which would be the non-Ram Air. So those were your options on the GT. It also included those two hood pins that you see that come through the hood, and they are attached to the core support. It also came with those lanyards. It came with that non-functional hood scoop. If you got Ram Air, it would have came with it would not have had those, but those have the turn indicators inside the hood scoop itself. It came with the sport mirrors on the side, the twin sport mirrors. It came with dual exhaust. Actually, it's a faux dual exhaust because it runs through a single transverse muffler with dual exhaust tips, actually quad tips, out the back with two cutouts. The GT package also came with the side stripes and a special pop-open GT gas cap.
Almost forgot, styled steel wheels were standard on the GT and Mach 1, but the GT got the GT center cap,
as well as competition suspension. So that was what you got for $146. You got some stripes, you got a little bit of this, you got a little bit of that. Came with a quick ratio steering box as well, the 16:1. Came with a larger sway bar, which is part of the competition suspension package. A little different rate springs. And then kind of those other accoutrements that also came on the Mach 1. So there you go. That's the long and the short of it. This car also had the electric clock, which was an option for $15. Optional wide oval tires, $14. Power front disc brakes were $64. Wow, air conditioning, look at that, $379. You had to have some deep wallets to get AC back in the late 60s, early 70s. The AM/FM stereo radio was $181. They're hard to find today because so many people tossed them. I mean, the quality really wasn't that good, and people started upgrading stereo equipment in the 70s, was very popular. And so this has got tossed, so they're hard to find today. They're expensive. They're an expensive item to get. Full-width front seat, that's that highly unusual bench seat. Last year for the bench seat in 69, also GT, last year of the GT was 1969 until they were reintroduced in 1983. The interior decor group, that's the Mach 1 style wood grain door panels, and I actually put the inserts in the wood grain inserts updated in the clusters as well. And it also came with tinted glass. So if you look at this, look at that, $4,299. So someone spent a lot of money on that little coupe. From $27,400, they optioned it with $1,437 in options.
And just quickly, I forgot to mention the power steering was a factory, and so was the optional axle ratio in that 9-inch rear end.
So pretty cool stuff, and a very unique and rare car. So, you know, I'm glad I spent the time and the energy and the money on it. And again, if you'd like to get one of these window stickers, these replica window stickers, these Mustang stickers, if you will, you can contact Tony, and I'm going to flash up his information.
So special thanks to Tony again, and by all means, let him know you saw this on Mustang Connection.
And this makes a really cool thing to stick this in the window, and it really adds, you know, someone go, wow, look at it's kind of a fun conversation piece, too, to see what things cost. Just to see that. So anyway, I thought it was kind of fun, kind of a neat deal. So again, if you want to talk to Tony, let him know you saw it here on Mustang Connection. Again, window stickers, mustangstickers.com rather. And you can order these up for pretty much anything 65 through the early 70s. And it makes for a great piece for show, auction, selling it, you know, just a conversation piece. And a nice, you know, I'm going to put this in with the rest of my paperwork. So I have all the build sheets and all that stuff. So it just kind of makes for a nice package to have, you know, the original build sheets and all this good stuff, you know, in with there. So there you go. Thanks a lot. Thumbs up, please. Thanks for watching Mustang Connection. We'll see y'all soon. And stay tuned. We're going to be doing a lot of auction coverage coming up. So thumbs up. See ya.